नित्यानन्देश्वर सदाशिव समारंभां नित्यानन्देश्वरि आदिशक्तिमध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वंदे गुरुपरंपरां। I welcome you all with my love and respects. First, let's offer our devotion to Mahaganapati on the 9th day of Brahmotsavam. He is gracing in Sandana Alankara on Swarna Gajavahana, golden elephant vehicle. Let's receive his grace, then we will move to the satsang.
ಧೂಪಂ ಆಘ್ರಾಪಯಾಮಿ। ಅಥ ದೀಪ ಓಮುದೀಪ್ಯಸ್ವಜಾತ ವೇದೋ ಪಗ್ನಿರ್ನಿರುತಿಂ ಮಮ ವಶೋಗಶ್ಚ ಮಹ್ಯಮಾವಹ ಜೀವನಂ ಚ ದಿಶೋ ದಿಶ ಮಾನೋ ಹಿಗಂ ಧೀಜಾತ ವೇದೋ ಕಾಮಶ್ವಂ ಪುರುಷಂ ಜಗತ್ ಅಭಿಭ್ರತಜ್ಞಾಗಿಹಿ ಶ್ರಿಯಾ ಮಾ ಪರಿಪಾದಯ। ಶ್ರೀ ಮಹಾಗಣಾಧಿಪತಯೇ ನಮಃ ದೀಪಂ ದರ್ಶಯಾಮಿ। ನೈವೇದ್ಯಂ ಓಂ ಮಧುವಾತಾರಿತಾಯ ತೇ ಮಧುಕ್ಷರಂತಿ ಸಿಂಧವಃ ಮಾಧ್ವೀರ್ನ ಸಂತೋಷದೀಹಿ ಮಧುನಕ್ತ ಮುತೋಷಧಿ ಮಧುನ ಪಾತಿ ವಗಮೃಜಃ ಮಧುಧ್ಯೋರಸ್ತು ನಃ ಪಿತಾ ಮಧುಮಾನೋ ವನಸ್ಪತಿರ್ಮಧುಮಾಗಂ ಅಸ್ತು ಸೂರ್ಯಃ ಮಾಧ್ವೀರ್ಗಾವೋ ಭವಂತು ನಃ ಮಧೋ ಮಧೋ ಮಧೋ। ಶ್ರೀ ಮಹಾಗಣಾಧಿಪತಯೇ ನಮಃ ನೈವೇದ್ಯಂ ನಿವೇದಯಾಮಿ। ಮಂಗಲ ನೀರಾಜನಂ ಓಂ ಏಕದಂತಾಯ ವಿದ್ಮಹೇ ವಕ್ರತುಂಡಾಯ ಧೀಮಹಿ ತನ್ನೋ ದಂತಿ ಪ್ರಚೋದಯಾತ್। ಓಂ ಏಕದಂತಾಯ ವಿದ್ಮಹೇ ವಕ್ರತುಂಡಾಯ ಧೀಮಹಿ ತನ್ನೋ ದಂತಿ ಪ್ರಚೋದಯಾತ್। ಓಂ ಏಕದಂತಾಯ ವಿದ್ಮಹೇ ವಕ್ರತುಂಡಾಯ ಧೀಮಹಿ ತನ್ನೋ ದಂತಿ ಪ್ರಚೋದಯಾತ್। ಕರ್ಪೂರಗೌರಂ ಕರುಣಾವತಾರಂ ಸಂಸಾರಸಾರಂ ಬುಜಗೇಂದ್ರಹಾರಂ ಸದಾ ವಸಂತಂ ಹೃದಯಾರವಿಂದೇ ಭವಂ ಭವಾನಿ ಸಹಿತಂ ನಮಾಮಿ ಭವಂ ಭವಾನಿ ಸಹಿತಂ ನಮಾಮಿ ಭವಂ ಭವಾನಿ ಸಹಿತಂ ನಮಾಮಿ।
Yes, I welcome every one of you with my love and respects. Just wanted to tell you, I did not think I'll be able to speak today, but I decided to speak just to tell you this fundamental understandings, how we take life for granted, and only when it is not there we realize, we understand its value. All of you take morning satsang for granted. Only when I am sitting here today for more than 1 hour, even to get ready to utter few words and then almost full 2 minutes of preparation of my breathing and everything to start speaking, I understand. I don't know whether you all understand or not. Even I was taking morning satsang for granted. Many things we take it for granted. When it is easily available, I tell you, anything, when you take it for granted, you push that from your life to death. It is no more living for you. Listen, whether it is health or money or some people in your life, or some place, situation, the moment you take that for granted, it is no more kindling your life, kundalini shakti, energy to be alive. It has become dead part of you. Even a temple, if you take that for granted, it is no more a spiritually awakening, kundalini kindling place. It is part of your dead unconscious process. I was seeing that during the kirtan, just playing with their iPhone. I don't know what they are doing with their phone. It is utterly taking this space for granted. That is the reason, the idea that he is here and it is celebration is dead of the unconscious part. It is not kundalini kindling experience. One example, understand, life is kept as fragile by Sadashiva, so you won't take it for granted. Of course, I am going to be alive in the body for quite a long time. I am going to be operating, available in the body for quite a long time. All that is true. But if you are taking it for granted, somehow it will not be available for you. Either you will not be in this center, ashram, you will be in some branch, or multiple reasons. There are tons of reasons. How what you are having today, you may not have it tomorrow. Because life is fragile, understand. Million things congregate together to make this one happening of you and me in my breathing space. Understand? Millions of things congregate together to make you and me in my breathing space. Never take it for granted. Never take it for granted. Anything taken for granted is no more part of life. It's not part of life. It is just a dead mechanism. Not even a mechanism, machine. Even mechanism has certain life. Just machine. Understand? The moment you think, oh, every day comes and sits, what is there? Over. It is no more Kundalini kindling experience. It's your dead past. It's your dead past. When this is your dead past, Kalabhairava will make sure you are moved to the periphery. Because the people who are really enjoying without taking it for granted, they need the space. Too many people are interested, too many want. So naturally the space will be, you will be vacated for them to be accommodated. Understand? Anything. When you don't take it for granted, breathes its life into you. When you take it for granted, it becomes dead component of you. Too many things taken for granted makes your life dead. Makes your life utterly dead. Nothing can excite you, nothing can inspire you, nothing can kindle your kundalini. Everything is just dead component of you. When you reach that kind of a arrogant space, that is what I call depression. Biggest epidemic going on all over the world, spreading. I don't know how many of you know. Blue whales. Biggest epidemic going on. No other epidemic. Dengue, H1N1 took so many lives. Psychological epidemic. Disease is spreading all over the world. Youngsters are committing suicide left and right in that blue whales games. What do you think is the reason? Taking life for granted. I'll speak elaborately about it maybe in next few satsangs. First thing I want to tell, ban blue whales. That's the only way you are going to save him. Youngsters for future. Of course, in all our Sangha, in all our organizations, ban blue whales games. It is a games in the internet where adventurous things are supposed to be done by you. Finally, it ends in your suicide. Youngsters, kids are very systematically taught life negative concepts with the game. So one by one, they complete that game and they get the kick. The game kick is exceeding even the respect for life. Then you are taught the suicidal techniques like jumping from the 70th floor or drinking poison, all kinds of suicidal techniques, and it is spreading like epidemic. Disease, and no other epidemic disease like H1N1 or dengue or bird flu killed so many people in such short time. And this unusual self-harming horror techniques the controlling and manipulating people who are controlling the manipulators of the game, finally make the players believe the whole life is waste and make them take it for granted, and doing horrible things like a self-harming and suicide as very exciting, and tasks like cutting oneself, taking other risks for contemplating on death, and two scary things. But why do you think all these are spreading? Even if the blue whales is subdued, the game is not going to end. Like this, somebody is going to come up with some other whales. As long as taking life for granted is not addressed, not attended, these kind of games are going to come up. These kind of games are going to be invented, and they are going to spread. Unless we address the root issue, taking life for granted means making life into death. Without even opening the paycheck, dropping it in the dustbin, thinking that it's a waste old newspaper. Understand, taking life for granted is equivalent to dropping your paycheck in the dustbin, thinking it's a waste old newspaper, or the mail from a person from whom you don't want to see anything or read, or used toilet tissue. If you think your paycheck is used toilet tissue and drop it in the dustbin, that is exactly what you are doing when you take life for granted, when you don't involve with it, when you don't live it, when you don't involve with it. I tell you, life in any form is prasad of Sadashiva. Taking it for granted is using your paycheck, actually dropping your paycheck in dustbin, thinking it's a used toilet tissue. Essence of today's satsang: don't take life for granted. Don't take Nitya Satsang for granted. Don't take inner awakenings for granted. Don't take Mahasadashivoham for granted. Don't take Nitya Satsang for granted because it is happening every day. Don't take inner awakening for granted because it is happening every month. Don't take Mahasadashivoham for granted because it is happening every year. Don't take anything for granted. So with this, I bless you all. Let's all radiate with integrity, authenticity, responsibility, enriching, causing, living Shuddhadvaita Saivam, Sadashivoham, the eternal bliss, Nityananda. Thank you. Be blissful.